The next question for our noble Sheikh, it says, can we stand up for ta'zim? And connected to that, what is the concept of celebration in the light of Quran and Sunnah?
Good.
So, can we stand up for ta'zim?
Yes. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I will again give you the brief answer, but I would like to refer one of my books on this subject. This is again my book, Kitab al-Tawheed, and I am quoting the second volume of my book, Kitab al-Tawheed. The full chapter in it is page 41. Ta'zim, the standing for ta'zim, you have to keep in your mind that first of all, this is doing ta'zim in general. Ta'zim means to respect, to rever, to honor. This is an act of respect, act of honoring, act of reverence. Itself, for Anbiya, for Rusul, for Awliya, for blessed places, for parents, for shuyukh, ta'zim in general is fard. This is compulsory, not only allowed, this is compulsory in Islam. Some people, by mistake, misunderstand the concept of ta'zim and they mix it with concept of ibadah. So you have to clearly differentiate between worship and reverence. Ta'zim is not ibadah. Ibadah is just for Allah, and ta'zim is for everybody except Allah. You have to keep in your mind. Ibadah is the right, exclusive right for Allah, reserved for Allah. And ta'zim is a right for everybody except Allah. Because the highest grade of ta'zim, where ta'zim converts into ibadah, that is for Almighty Allah. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. And right from Alhamd to Wannas, you will never find a single Quranic verse where it is stated that we do ta'zim for you, O Almighty Allah. Wherever in Quran ta'zim is mentioned for the creations. For example, stated, وَمَنْ يُعَزِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Those who perform ta'zim for the mountains of Safa and Marwa, they are in fact performing the taqwa of their hearts. So you are doing ta'zim of the mountains, As-Safa and Al-Marwa. Those who perform ta'zim of Sha'irullah, Allah's signs. What are the Allah's signs? Quran says, Inna Safa wal Marwata min Sha'airillah. Safa and Marwa, these two mountains, these are Sha'airullah, Allah's signs. And Quran says, وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. So doing ta'zim, performing ta'zim for Sha'airullah, the Safa and Marwa, this is Allah's taqwa. So ta'zim is permitted even up to the extent of mountains. You can do ta'zim of Kaaba, you have to do. You have to do ta'zim of the whole of city of Makkah, the trees of Makkah and Medina, the street of Medina, the walls of Medina, the bricks of Medina. You can't do any act which is permissible otherwise, but that is not permissible in Haram, Makkah and Medina. That's why you say it Haram. That the halal things becomes haram in Makkah and Medina. The pray, the fight, all these things are related to ta'zim. And there are many other, for example, lowering down your voice for Holy Prophet, this is ta'zim. La tarfau aswatakum fawqa sawti an-nabi. This is ta'zim. So these are various forms of ta'zim. Another form of ta'zim which Quran mentions is to take your shoes off for some blessed and respectable or from blessed place. In Quran, when Musa alayhi salam wanted to, was called and he went near Tur Sina. He said, Ya Musa, fakhla na'alayk innaka bilwadi al-muqaddasi tuwa. You have come in the holy valley where the light of Almighty Allah was illuminating. So since you are coming to near to his proximity, fakhla na'alayk, take your shoes off. So this is again a form, a demonstration, a format of performing ta'zim. In the same way, as I mentioned various forms, standing for somebody is also a form of ta'zim. Standing for somebody. Some people say, but no, standing for someone in ta'zim is shirk because standing is for Almighty Allah. So this is totally a nonsense to say. Why standing is for Allah? Where did he say just standing is just only for me? If you mean by the qiyam of the salat, qiyam, standing is for Allah. If the standing is for Allah, to who is sitting for? When you sit in tashahud, whom you are sitting for? It means while qiyam you are standing for Allah, and in tashahud at-tahiyyatu lillahi wa salawat, whom you are sitting for? Then sitting is also for Allah because the whole sum of prayer is for Allah. The whole prayer is for Allah. If you pick the portions of prayer and say the standing is for Allah, then sitting is also for Allah. So the question is then if standing is prohibited, so sitting is also prohibited. If standing is prohibited, then sitting is also prohibited. So if those who do ta'zim while standing, if they are doing wrong, so those who don't want to stand, they want to keep sitting, they are also performing the same sin. Because the prayer consists of two conditions. Qiyam is standing, and Qu'ud, Tashahud is in sitting. So sitting is as well as sitting and Qiyam, both are for Almighty Allah, and prostrating, these are also for Allah. So that becomes shirk only if you stand with the niyyah of ibadah. Keep in your mind, if you stand up for someone with the niyyah of ibadah, this is known as qiyam al ibadah. That my standing of worship is for someone. If you make this niyyah intention, it is kufr. In the same way, you can do the same niyyah while sitting. I am sitting here for ibadah. Not many people, the Buddhist, go to the temples of Buddhist and Hindus, they perform their worship while sitting. They sit in front of idols and statues. They don't stand normally. They sit in front of statues and they do everything while sitting. So some people worship while sitting, some people worship while standing. So sitting or standing does not make any difference. Difference is the niyyah. Innamal amalu bin niyyat. If you sit or stand with the niyyah of worshipping, with the niyyah of worshipping, it becomes prohibited, kufr. And if you stand for anyone or sit for anyone without niyyah of worship, just for ta'zim, I told already, ta'zim is for the people, for your parents, for your teachers, for your shuyukh, for other people, if you stand for them or sit for them, for example, so it is always permissible. This is act of ta'zim and not act of ibadah. And Quran says, now I told you, two sittings, standing and sitting. Now come, what about lying down? When you lie down, Quran at one place mentions, lie down is also for Allah. Now take away your beds from your houses. Quran says, Allazina yazkuruna Allah qiyaman wa qu'udan wa ala junubihim. Those who remember Almighty Allah while standing and sitting and lying down on your beds. So what will you say? Here all the three conditions have been reserved for Allah: standing, sitting and lie down. So what does it mean? If you lie down on your bed with your children, with your family, just on your own, is it a sin and kufr and shirk? You are, why does your lying down, why it does not become shirk? It is niyya. You are lying down for rest, for sleep. So that is the sleep which differentiated your position, stature of lying down from lying down of worshipping. And if you are ill, and if you are ill, you can't get up, stand up. You can pray lying down or your bed or not. So even lying down or bed can also be a state of praying. So what is the main decisive thing, factor? Decisive factor is your niyya. Innamal amalu bin niyyat. If you have the niyya of worship, you, if you are doing any act while lying down, it will also become kufr. There is no difference between standing and sitting and lying down or even walking. So the ta'zim, standing for ta'zim is sunnah. The last thing, standing for ta'zim is sunnah. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used himself, he make it sunnah. It is in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, muttafaq alayh. When Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to come, there are seven kinds of standing other than ibadah. One kind of standing is prohibited. Standing means for other people, not for God. Just one is prohibited, and that is standing of worship. And seven kinds of standings are permissible. How many kinds? Seven kinds of standings are permissible, and they are established through Quran and Sunnah of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One is standing for reception. Standing for reception. A companion, it comes in Sahih Bukhari, Hadith Sahih. Hazrat Saad radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he was head of his own tribe. He came, he was riding on some camel or whatever was there. When he came near the mosque, Holy Prophet ﷺ commanded, order. The Ansar people sitting around him said, Qumu ila sayyidikum. Wa fi riwayatin Qumu ila khayrikum. Go stand up to your leader, to your chief of your tribe. This is Sahih Bukhari. So this is commandment of Holy Prophet ﷺ. If any elder, your sheikh, your head, your teacher, what to talk of the Prophet and Holy, the Messenger. When he comes, Holy Prophet said, "Qumu ila sayyidikum." You should stand up to him, for him. And the other, some people say, very interesting thing, very interesting. Some people misinterpret this hadith. This hadith is Sahih Bukhari, Kitabul Maghazi, number 2. Again, Bukhari quotes in second place, Sahih Bukhari, Kitabul Istizan. And he has, Imam Bukhari has fixed a chapter, full-fledged chapter, with the caption of standing in Sahih Bukhari. Qumu ila sayyidikum. This is the caption, heading of the chapter, which Imam Bukhari has brought in Sahih Bukhari. Then this hadith is muttafaq alayh, comes in Sahih Muslim, Kitabul Jihad. Same hadith comes in Sunan Abi Dawood, Kitabul Adab. And Imam Abu Dawood has fixed a chapter with this caption, Babu Maja'a fil Qiyam. This is a chapter in standing. Books of hadith bring the chapter of standing. What wrong has occurred to the people nowadays? So some people wrongly interpret this hadith. They say that Saad was ill. He was injured. He was ill. This is not in hadith. This thing has never come in. This is their interpretation. They say that this may be the reason that he was ill, and Holy Prophet wanted his people to go there to help him coming down from the camel or coming down from the donkey, whatever he was riding on. This is one, their answer. So let me explain. Sorry, this is a very wrong answer. It does not appeal to common sense. If he was ill or he was injured, so Holy Prophet would have asked only one person or two go and help him in coming down. He is saying the whole company, maybe 12, 20, 25, 30, 50 people go to him and stand up. If anybody is ill, 50 people are needed to go to bring him down, or only one person or two to help him? It doesn't make any sense. He would have asked only one person, oh, Mr. You, go and help him in bringing down. And he would have said, help him in coming down. He neither used the word help, nor did he order just single person or two persons to go. He said, Kumu, all of you should stand up for him. This is Bukhari, Muslim, Muttafaq Alayh. I don't think any other thing has left after that. If the standing is Holy Prophet's command for Hazrat Saad, a companion, and why? He said, Khairakum, he is your chief, he is your head. So what would be wrong if somebody stands up while saying Salam on Holy Prophet just in the respect and reverence of his name, and reverence of his mentioning, and reverence of his zikr? This is one. Second kind of standing is Qiyam-e-Muhabbat. Al-Qiyam-ul-Muhabba, standing for love. Holy Prophet himself used to stand when Sayyida Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to see her. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, Ummul Mumineen, whenever Sayyida Fatima used to come to our house to see his father, to her father, Holy Prophet always used to stand up for her. And not only standing, he kissed her hands. And she kissed him. When Holy Prophet used to go to Hazrat Fatima to see her, she used to stand up for him. And she used to kiss his hands. So standing for somebody is the sunnah of Holy Prophet and the companion. And kissing the hands is sunnah. Even kissing the feet is sunnah. Kissing the feet. It is Imam Bukhari has made a full chapter on kissing of feet. In Al-Adab al-Mufrad, kissing of hands, kissing of feet, and standing. All these modes. Then there is Qiyam al-Faraha, standing for happiness and pleasure. For example, somebody, your son, he won the match, he came first, he brought the medal. As soon as he entered, for happiness, you all of a sudden you stand up. Come on, my son. This is known as standing of pleasure and excitement. This is permissible. Standing for reception is permissible. Standing for love is permissible. Standing for tazim, kumu ila sayyidikum, is permissible. Standing for ikramul insan, just respect of human body. Holy Prophet, it comes in Bukhari, Muslim, Muttafaq Alayh. Whenever Holy Prophet saw any dead body funeral, he used to stand up for the funeral. If any funeral passed in front of him, he always used to stand up. It is in Sahih Bukhari. Once a companion told him secretly, Ya Rasulullah, he is a Jew. The dead man, the funeral, this person was a Jew. Then Holy Prophet said, you are telling me Jew, was he not a human being? This standing for respect and honor is for the human body, human being. So he used to stand for the funerals. What kind of ummah we are? We are objecting to standing for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to stand for the Jews' funerals. This was his morality, his etiquettes. Then standing of zikr, remembrance. Yazkuruna Allah qiyama wa qu'udan. Just for zikr. You can stand for zikr. You stand for azan. You stand for salat and salam. You stand for azkar, so it is common. Then stand for salam. When you say salam, you stand up. Now the last thing is, when it is stated in Holy Quran, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Almighty Allah and all of his angels keep on sending salat and salam on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Is it clear? These angels and all angels. Do you know the positions of angels? There are some angels who keep on standing throughout their life. They don't sit. There are angels who always remain worshipping in sitting. Some angels always keep on prostrating. So any angel, whatever position he has, he says salat and salam on Holy Prophet. So those who are sitting, they keep on saying darood and salam while sitting. Those who are standing, they keep darood and salam while they are standing. So sending darood and salam while standing is the sunnah of the angels. And then the sunnah of 100,000 companions. Saying salam on Holy Prophet while standing. You know, when Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, there was no funeral prayer read on him. Do you know this thing? Now today, keep in your mind. There were no formal funeral prayer on him. I'm repeating the words again and again. Because the funeral prayers are on the dead. And Holy Prophet was never dead. Just keep on your mind in Hadith and Seerah. Nobody can establish that a proper traditional funeral prayer, which we read on the dead people and dead body funeral, that funeral prayer was never read and prayed on Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why? Because the words of the funeral prayer are Allahumma ighfir li hayyina wa mayyitina. Forgive our alive and forgive our dead. And because the funeral dead body is in front of you, you say the forgive him this dead. And Holy Prophet was never the dead. His spirit was separated from his body for a while, and then it was returned to him. Then it was returned to him, and he is still alive in his grave, and he will remain alive till the day of judgment. That's why he listens our durood and salam, and the angels place our durood and salam to him. So what did they say? No, there was no imam on the funeral prayer. There were no lines and the sufuf for funeral prayer. No traditional funeral prayer was done. What was done? Room was small. 100,000, all thousands of companions, they enter from one door. 10 or 20 companions stood in front of Holy Prophet and read salam on Holy Prophet. Tazim. They did tazim. Just they did tazim and read salam and went away, passed away through the other door. Then another 10, 20 people entered the room. They did tazim, standing tazim, and they read salam and went out through other door. This is how 3 days took, or 2 days. Thousands of the companion did tazim and read salam on Holy Prophet. You do the same tazim and same salam on Holy Prophet in the sunnah of the companions. I have given you just a few. There are hundreds of evidences in Hadith on this subject. And the last thing, it comes in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. I told you last time, I think maybe in the first lecture or something like that, that Azan is a call to prayer. Azan is a call to prayer. And you know what was Iqamah, the beginning, where this Iqamah started from. The Iqamah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and the people stood up. This Iqamah means standing, to make people stand. Iqamah means to make people stand. So Iqamah was always for Holy Prophet. When Holy Prophet used to come out from his house, only then Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala used to start the Iqamah. And as soon as they start Allahu Akbar, they came to know that Holy Prophet has come out. They used to stand up in his respect, in his tazim, in his respect, in his honor. So Iqamah became the sunnah as tazim for Holy Prophet and standing for Holy Prophet. And the last thing always keep in your mind, when Allah says sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima, Quran has never mentioned the posture, and Holy Prophet has never specified the posture, the position, that you can read salam only while sitting, or you can read salam only while standing. It is known al-mutlaqu yajri ala itlaqihi wal-muqayyadu yajri ala taqyidihi. This is the usul, the principle of Sharia. If the commandment of Quran and Hadith is absolute, when commandments are like that, then only then you can't make them qualify. You can't qualify them. If the commandment comes in itself as a conditional or qualified commandment, you can't make it open, general or absolute. So the order commandment, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima, read salat on Holy Prophet and read salam on Holy Prophet, this is an absolute commandment. This is an absolute commandment. There is no specification of posture and position. There is no specification and condition of your posture that you have to read Durood and Salaam while sitting or while standing or this way or that way. So no person in the whole world has this Sharia authority to qualify the commandment which has come out to us in the form of absolute. So it depends upon you. If you want to do Tazim, stand and read Salaam, this is according to Sunnah, permissible according to Quran. If anybody wants to read Salat and Salaam while sitting, he is not doing any sin. He is not doing any. Let him read. His heart is happy and excited to read Salaam while sitting. Let him do sitting. You want to read Durood and Salaam. When you enter, for example, you stand up for your teacher. The Americans stand up for Obama. For Bush, don't they stand? The British people, they stand up for Queen. The whole world stand up for their elders, for their presidents. What kind of ummah would be that they are not ready to stand up for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Whereas it is permissible by Quran and the Sunnah of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And always keep in the mind, the people quote only two things. One, sometimes Holy Prophet prohibited people to standing. He was a teacher. His responsibility was to coach and teach everybody. So wherever you find the one commandment of prohibiting, and he disliked the people to stand, this was a coaching for the person who is coming, that the one who is entering, he should not like for himself, and he should not wish that people may stand for him. This was a training for him. The prohibition means that the one who is coming, he should not wish that people should stand for him. If he wishes that people should stand for him, this is a great sin. And he is the one who is absolutely not entitled to be stood for. The one who wishes. This is arrogance. So prohibition, the hadith which contains prohibition, they are only to educate those people who are coming. They should not wish that people should stand for them. One thing. And there is one hadith in which Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu quotes in Adabul Mufrad, Imam Bukhari says that once Holy Prophet came and we did not stand up. That was a specific event. Holy Prophet sometimes came twice or thrice in a meeting. He was already sitting there. He used to come for leading the prayer. And he forgot anything, went back. When he went, people had already stood for him. He went back. At that time he used to say, don't stand for me, because they had already done their act of tazim. If he went twice or thrice, so that was a specific occasion when he said, don't stand. If he ordered, don't stand. So they are compelled to perform that order. So it doesn't mean that this one incident would abrogate the whole sunnah of the life, because the companions always used to stand. Even when he used to go back to his house, in the end of the meeting, it comes in Hadith Sahih, companions say that it was our practice throughout our life. Whenever Holy Prophet stood up, all of us used to stand up. And we used to keep standing till he entered his house and disappeared. So that was the practice throughout the life. One incident having a specific reason when he prohibited, I am coming again, second time, third time, don't stand. One specific conditional incident cannot repeal or abrogate the hadith and sunnah of the whole life. That is perpetual. I think I am clear and you are also clear on this subject. No need, inshallah, further to ask this question again.